One, two.
Hello, and welcome to Pilot Knob. Now, for those of you who do not know, I was born and raised, so I am right at home, and I'll give you a shot of the knob here in a little bit. We are out identifying wild edibles, as well as plants you can use medicinally. So the first one on our chart that we've arrived at is the wild sweet violet. Now, as you can see, she covers the ground. She will be located in your more acidic soil. So if you're trying to identify where my acidic soil is on my property, just look for the wild sweet violets. She will cover that ground. Now, what's wonderful about her is in the springtime, you get these beautiful blooms. And the one thing that I want you to know about is she is related to the sweet pea. She comes from the sweet pea family. And so if you look at the back of her, the bloom of her is just like a sweet pea. Now, they are crunchy, tasty. They are wonderful delicacies. If you want to crystallize these with sugar, you can eat them on your tossed salad.
Is that one sweet?
Mm-mm. They don't have a sweet taste. They have a crunchy, lettucey green taste.
So then that's probably the sororia instead of the odorata.
Mm-hmm.
Odorata, rather, which the odorata, I think, is the sweet one. Is that right?
Well, they can be. It depends. Now, remember, the area and environment that you live in and the soil will always take up. And since they carry those nutrients and spread them out, you could get a crunchy taste like I've got. Sometimes it might be a little bit too green tasting, but that's okay. The great thing about them is you can top these on a beautiful tall salad. And if you steep them, your vinegar will be this beautiful violet color. It will be a pink violet color. Now, the easiest way to identify violets when all the blooms are gone, and let me iterate that. If the bloom is white, that happens sometimes. It won't be purple, it'll be white, or it'll have white with purple in it. That's simply okay. But the best way to identify it is her leaves will be shaped like a heart. Now, what that tells us about any herb with this heart-shaped leaf is it's going to strengthen the immune system. Not necessarily the heart, but the whole blood supply immune system, because it is full of vitamin C. So for ladies who are fighting against cellulite, preserving youth, and preserving the adaptogen hormone in your body to keep all your vital organs young, you would benefit from using wild sweet violets. And when they're not in bloom, use the leaves. The leaves are not going to be tasty on a salad. They're just not appetizing, but they're really wonderful if you steep them in oils and make your skincare creams or salves, your lotions, or you can bathe in them. Just dry them and bathe in them. Make you a steeping bath with them tied up in a little bag and just let them float around in the tub. The great thing about them is they're wonderful for your capillaries, varicose veins, and they keep down the contracting of that so that the blood flows naturally. And of course, with all the vitamin C, it helps to protect the immune system, but it also serves as a stimulator. So it makes all the other nutrients work real well together. It makes sure everybody gets their part throughout your body. So let's see what else we can hunt.